this is my laptop. It's my daily tool to coding and also to connecting my laptop to the high performance computational system, HPC, to run my codes and also to analyze all the data from satellite. So for this larger satellite, we can probably measure, for example, the vegetation plants at 10 meters at a global scale. And this cube size can even measure at 3 meters somehow for global scale. So it's fascinating. And how can we best use all of this large data sets, and in particular this high resolution new data, to better understand the whole Earth system, is always interesting and also inspires me to, you know, to use all sorts of technology to better understand and better discover new things from the satellite data. Because we cannot directly measure all these variables like soil moisture from satellite, you know, from images, it's not possible. So we have to use some physical models to combine these computational models and the data from satellites to better estimate all sorts of water cycle variables, and then use the data to better understand how the climate change influenced the water cycle, and also what's the feedbacks from water cycle change to the climate change, to the atmosphere. And also, you know, use the data to understand, in particular, I mean, last years we all experienced the climate extremes, so droughts, floods, right? So how can we use this remote sensing products to better quantify and understand the climate extremes influence on the ecosystem? Our models can help us to predict and forecast the future water change. And then in the beginning I told you somehow it's like the hydroclimatic extremes, so floods, droughts. So how can we use remote sensing data together with models to provide the best simulation and also best forecasting for the future? That's something I want to resolve using the remote sensing data.